the question that we're going to answer tonight is the Christian in college. Welcome to this episode of the Word Unbound. The Word Unbound exists to help make biblically minded Christians by examining common questions through the lens of Scripture. My name is Will Sanderson, and I am joined here tonight by my esteemed colleague, Conrad Mills. Conrad, how's it going?
It's great. It's been a while since we've recorded one of these.
Yeah, how's it feel to have it mixing up? You know, the
It's weird, but I think I'll get used to it.
Yeah, yeah. Well, and the reason we're doing that is because I think you're going to be able to have a different perspective on the question that we're answering, considering you went through it more recently than I did. And the question that we're going to answer tonight is the Christian in college.
Yeah, that's a topic that we could do a few episodes on. I think it's, you know, because when you think about being a Christian in college, there's a lot of different ways you can go with this conversation, because how do I, you know, what do I do being a Christian in college? Where am I going to college? Am I going to a Christian college that makes it easy for me to be a Christian? Am I going to a public university, a secular university where it's not the normal thing? So there are a lot of different ways we can take this conversation, but I think where we want to start is, I'm a Christian. I'm going to college. Let's just take a generic public university, because that's where most people go to college. Yeah. What do I do? And I think that's because people think it's hard to be a Christian in college, which it's probably just about the same. It's just as hard to be a Christian in college as it is as out in the workforce as an adult.
That's fair.
It's not something that is harder, you know, in college than a different point of life. Being a Christian in college really has a few different facets to it, but I think the first thing that a Christian, a freshman going into college who is worried about, hey, I want to live my faith, I want to be what God has called me to be during this time in my life, I think the first thing that you need to do in that season is find a healthy local church. Because a lot of times, you know, we see people go into parachurch organizations, which are not bad. I think they serve their purpose if used correctly. But I think that's, you know, the first thing is find a good, healthy local church, become a member, get plugged in, be serving there, be submitted to the elders, be active in a small group, and be serving the Lord worshipfully there.
A place where you can learn.
Yeah.
And a place where you can serve mm-hmm. and be served.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, would you have anything to add to that on finding a local church? I know we've done an episode on how to find a church. Suggest listening to that.
Yeah, and I would say, and we even said this when we were talking about the local church, that, I mean, sometimes in your college church process, you should pick where you want to go to church first and then the college around that, right? Mm-hmm. If you're going to a place, like, make sure that there's a place that will feed your soul. Don't let this be something you figure out once you get on campus. Maybe you have a few in mind that you want to check out and that you want to see, but don't sit there and say, okay, now I'm on campus, I've unpacked and I've gone through orientation, and now let's try to find a church.
Yeah, and another thing too, so the first thing is just find a healthy local church. Mm-hmm. But another thing that was kind of, that I saw a lot in college was that studies often came before church. Mm-hmm. And yes, while you are at school to get a degree, you are at school to get a degree so that you can go out into the workforce and be a productive member of society, that does not supersede, your homework does not supersede small group. Your homework does not supersede going to church on Sunday. It doesn't, gathering with the body of Christ. Yeah. It's not, don't use your homework as an excuse to skip out on church, because honestly, gathering with the church as a Christian is way more important than your homework and what grade you get on that test.
Yeah. Yeah. And I think you see it with guys in college mm-hmm. that would say that they can't do discipleship. They can't be discipled because it's finals week. And I mean, I do get that there are certain weeks that are a little bit more intense or whatever, but I'd say if the norm is whenever you have a test, you shut down your Christian life, or at least your involvement in the local church, you're gonna find yourself not growing as much as you, if you didn't do that.
Yeah. Another thing too, college is such a rich time where you can be growing so incredibly much in your walk with the Lord, mm-hmm. or it can be a time where it's in spurts, where it's, you know, it's great for a season. And I mean, we all have that, right? Every Christian has that, but it's a time that you can really intentionally focus on growing your relationship with the Lord, where, you know, because in college, I mean, people say they're busy.
Yeah.
I had the privilege of being a part of a large parachurch organization, and I heard that. I heard stuff like that all the time of, you know, I got this test, I've got this thing to do, I've got that thing to do. And for me, I'm like, man, your relationship with Jesus is so much more important than if you get a 75 or an 85 on that test.
Yeah.
Because, you know, God works all things out how he wants. And so you're going to be placed wherever he wants you to in the workforce, regardless of whether you get that grade or not. Now, I'm not saying that don't study, that you don't try hard, that you don't do things to reflect the Lord. But at the same time, I mean, do not neglect what's most important.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I think also when it comes to being in college, you're going to have ups and downs mm-hmm. so much.
Mm-hmm.
And just because by the very nature of from one semester to another, your schedule is going to change so dramatically mm-hmm. from when you have classes to how much you're able to work to what job you're working, whether you have an internship or, you know, you're pursuing these different things. Like, make sure that you take that time to have that one constant in your life of mm-hmm. just feeding your soul in the Word and in prayer with the midst of all the ups and downs that's going on. Having that steadfast local church that you're involved in and that you're moved in, and don't let that your involvement in a parachurch organization rob you from the local church. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm saying this as one who got into that a little bit in college, not a ton, and then mm-hmm. found it in the local church, just, man, and there are so many young, and especially young single people that can be such a blessing to local church, and they're not there. They're noticeably absent.
Yeah, I can say this from experience, if I had it to go back to do over again, being heavily involved in a parachurch organization versus being heavily involved in the local church, I'd choose the local church 10 times out of 10.
Mm-hmm.
Because the local church is an eternal organization. The parachurch is not.
Yeah. I mean, Christ said, upon this rock, I'll build my church, not my parachurch, not my organization.
Mm-hmm.
And also, I mean, I just think about Hebrews mm-hmm. 10. I think this is a good passage for college students to not neglect the meeting together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as you see the day drawing near. This is just talking about that idea of just mm-hmm. don't neglect church. Don't neglect that local assembly, but mm-hmm. instead make sure that you're really pursuing that because, man, it is so important to your spiritual health and vitality. And so be involved, be there, and don't allow your busyness and your and side note, just if we're being completely honest here, the last thing a college person, student should say to someone older that is discipling them is that they're busy. Like, saying you're busy and you're tired are two things that you should just cut out of your vocabulary right now, because if you're doing life well, you should be, right? Yeah, you should be absolutely. Tired. You should be busy. And more than that, whoever you're saying that to probably feels like they're more busy and tired than you are, right? Mm-hmm. You, single guy who's taking 10 hours of college credits and mm-hmm. working 20 hours a week, is talking to the guy that, you know, is married and has 3 kids, 2 of which are under the age of 4, and works 40 hours a week and has a wife. Like, again, that's just a personal thing. But,
absolutely.
Just be careful with those phrases, because that just, you know, if you're doing life well.
Yeah.
And I think for a lot of times, there's some pride in being busy. Mm-hmm. And I think there's also like, hey, I'm doing things well. And also it could be for the very first time in their life, they really feel stretched mm-hmm. Because maybe high school is a lot easier than college is. And then I would also say, just to add, don't let your studies... And you've said this, don't let your studies supersede your spiritual growth. There is mm-hmm. going to be times where you need to stop and say, I've studied enough. I need to rest in the Lord. He's the one who causes me to remember. He's the one who causes me to forget. May he be the one who gets the grade always.
Mm-hmm.
And even if you crush it and you got a 4.0 all the way through college, give glory to the one who actually got those grades. Don't boast in yourself. Mm-hmm. Boast in him. Understand that you can work and work and work, and you can labor and toil and strive, and you should, for that is a gift that God has given to man, right? That he can toil and strive under the sun, yet
mm-hmm.
understand that there are times to rest and say, God, I've worked hard. I've worked diligently. May I go to bed? Mm-hmm. May I not pretend like I'm God, and that I can stay up all night and still function the way that you designed me to function.
Yeah.
That I can still fill myself with garbage and all kinds of 5-hour energies and nonstop and live beyond the means for which you have created me as a finite being,
mm-hmm.
but instead rest and trust in the efforts that you're able to put forward. And yeah, may he get the grade, may he get the glory.
Yeah, that's good stuff. I mean, it's all so true too. I mean, and also with college, it's a powerful time where you're changing. You're trying to figure out who you want to be. What's your identity? And number one, we're talking about the Christian in college. So your identity is that you are a Christian. Right. And for the Christian's goal is to be more like Jesus. And just a verse that comes to mind for me is 2 Corinthians 3:18. It says, and we all with unveiled face beholding the glory of the Lord are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another. For this comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. We're all, every Christian, we are being transformed into the likeness of Jesus Christ from one degree to another. Mm-hmm. That's what our purpose is here on earth, is to give him glory by becoming more like him. And college is a wonderful time that can happen in some really awesome ways that I know you probably haven't experienced before. And so let that be a motivation. Ask yourself the question, how can I be more like Jesus? How can I be growing to be more like Jesus? Whether that's by who you're getting discipled by, which you should be. Every mm-hmm. Christian should be. Discipleship is not an optional thing. Mm-hmm. You know, attending a church, and pick one church.
Yeah.
Do not church hop.
Yeah.
Pick one healthy local church, because when you church hop, this is a whole different episode, but you're acting like the church is about you and it's not, it's about God. Mm-hmm. And so just pick a church, be discipled, look to him and become more like him from one degree to another.
Yeah, these are formative years, mm-hmm. and so let them be formative in godliness, in discipleship, mm-hmm. in the local church. Love that. Super helpful. And so thank you for listening to this episode of The Word Unbound. The Word Unbound exists. No, that's what we do at the beginning. That's mm-hmm. okay. This is the first time I've done that. So thank you for listening to the episode of The Word Unbound. We pray that this information was helpful for you. And if it was helpful, we ask that you give us a like, give us a share, give mm-hmm. us a follow, and all that other social media kind of stuff. thank you, and we'll see you next time.
See you later.